Good afternoon, welcome to Music Scrap, the musical scrapper, also known as Jean Camo Magoo Sassy Pants. Let's see. Yeah, I think that's about it. And so I am live from the East Coast of Canada. If you're watching on YouTube recording, welcome, welcome. Hope you enjoy it. I don't edit these videos, so just fast forward, please, through any of the boring parts. Anyway, so let's say hello to the people who are here already. We have one anonymous. We have Ella, Eileen, Janet, Judy, Carrie, Lori. Hello, Lori, and everyone else. And we have Patty 72205. And we have Sarah O and Vicky S so far. So, let me see. Did it tweet me? Let's tweet. So, as I said, this is being recorded live, so there is a live studio audience. Haha, no, not a studio audience. A live chat audience. So, come on over someday if you want and are able to visit us live. This is our Canadian government logo. So I'm going to use this on my page. I'm going to play with some image transfers today, but I am also going to, I am going to do it most of today's stream in my art journal because it is an art journal page. I'm going to use different techniques of transfers on. Getting an idea from Carrie's stream the other day. And then Sherry also posted a coloring book transfer that she did that worked really well for her. So I am taking from there. So I'm going to move that over. Got a whole bunch of different like image ideas going on in my brain. So who knows if what I want to do will even all fit on my one page. Ha! Anyway, so hey Jillian, nice to see you. Hi Terry with an IE. Hey Judy Padooty. Alright, so alright. Oh, next thing, before while that's drying, before I start looking for another image, I want your guys' help. I'm doing this on Jen's behalf, and then I'll send the list to Jen. And she can add it to her blog and to the Facebook page or whatever. All right, so I want to make a list. Jen thought this was a good idea. Because people were wanting to, you know, gather stuff up and, you know, kind of play along as we are doing these art journaling techniques videos. Now, I'm not doing anything new. I'm going back to the image transfer idea techniques that we were talking about earlier, adding something that Carrie did also to, because whenever I heard her saying she was doing, you know, tried transfers with her coloring pages and it worked, and I was like, oh, I want to do that too. So I thought, yeah, how cool will that be? And whether they're colored or whether they're not colored, to use them. So I have some that I've already like I've already scanned into my computer so I could use them multiple times, so then I can use the originals as a... Hey, Carrie. Oh, hi, Jillian. Really? You had to pay duty on it? The only thing... That sucks, Jillian. The only thing I ever had to pay duty on was when my cameo arrived. And I knew exactly how much it was going to be, and it wasn't that bad. Of course, that was 4 years ago. The dollar was better back then. But usually, if it's under $175, you don't usually have to pay duty. Question for you, Jillian. Was it sent by UPS or by the post office? Hey, Lynn. Hey, Sam. Nice to see you. So, sorry, I got distracted in the middle by Jillian's cinch arriving with duty on it. Ugh, that sucks. Oh, yeah, it's a button. I was taking buttons off a sweater thing I was given. Okay, so far we've already done image transfers. We've done texture paste. And some are doing salt techniques. All right, so you guys help me make a list here for Jen. What else do you use? What other techniques do you use in your art, on your art journaling pages? It's a rainy day here, but at the moment the sun's trying to come through, but it's going to lose because we still have remnants of Colin hitting us, although it's quite a ways off coast now, but... need the house today. Oh, okay, stencils. Thank you, Ella. Okay, and stencil ghosting, which is different than just using stencil. Stencil ghosting. That's kind of a technique all on its own. Ooh, saran wrap. Good one. Book paper. So should we just use, of course we'll say collage then, right? Book paper, collage, bubble wrap. Because you can use bubble wrap to add paint or take paint away. With saran wrap, Vicky? Oh, saran wrap's really cool. What you do is you put watercolors or sprays. You can use like ink sprays or watercolor paints down on your page. And before they dry, you crinkle up saran wrap and then you lay it down on your page. And then you let it dry. Let the ink and whatever's under the saran wrap dry. So it takes a little while because you can't heat set it or you'll melt the saran wrap. So you have to lay it and let it dry. And when you remove the saran wrap, the watercolor and stuff, the ink has all pooled underneath the saran wrap and dried, leaving some really cool techniques. No problem, Sam. Okay, so I'll just say packing tape. And like through stencil transfer, etc. Lots of different ways you can use packing tape. Plastic wrap, Sam, plastic wrap. Kitchen plastic wrap. Saran wrap is just the name brand. Jelly prints. Come on, Eileen, you've got lots of... Of course, we can put like watercolors, using watercolor on your journal pages, right? Sprays. Hey, Z! Cling film? Okay. So for the UK people, saran wrap is cling film. Oh yeah, Jenna, good idea. Look at the art journaling prompt cards. Well, yeah, but True, Janet, but I want more than prompts. I want kind of specific techniques that we can focus on a technique for a video. You know, so kind of, yeah, but the prompt cards will definitely give you magazine images. Okay, turn the page. Oh, sorry, Eileen, I missed it. I must have been writing when you said alcohol inks. Oops. Sheesh, Eileen. Poor Eileen's losing chat. Okay, acrylic inks. Ways to use acrylic inks. I won't be able to do that one because I don't have any acrylic inks. Ooh, emboss resist. Good one, Janet. Yeah, sprays. I've got sprays, Vicky. Ooh, pan pastels. Good one. Pan pastels. How do you spell that? ELS, right. I always mess that up. You always want to use ELS. Hey, Debbie. Ooh, napkins. Good one, Debbie. We're just making a list for Jen to put on Facebook and perhaps do an order so that people can collect things if they want to play along and try and... Oh, Neo 2s. Or I'll say... water-soluble crayons. Okay. Yes, we could, Janet. Yeah, I have... Oh, I think I have packing tape. Yes, I have packing tape Z, thanks. Sorry about that. Chat's being a PETA the last, like, 2 weeks, really. It's been splitting and kicking people out. I do apologize. I can't do anything about it, though. Coloring pages. Yeah, I'm doing that one today. So, coloring pages. Oh, yeah, not... You mean just in general. Right. Coloring pages as, you know, elements of your, not necessarily, you know, as collage elements. Yeah. Ooh, Carol. Hi, Carol. Sunset Carol. Painting over an image. Good one. Yeah. Oh, dear Eileen. Okay. Oh, yeah. Tissue paper. Bleeding tissue paper. I have some of that. Was it Jillian? Was it you who sent me some? Someone sent me some. I think it was Jillian in a package that sent me some bleeding tissue. I've got to find that. Use that. Okay, so stencil. What would that be called? Negative stencil. What would that be called? How would we like that? Yeah, texture paste. We've got that one, Sam. We've got sprays. Oh, yeah. Now, Lynn, she said it was regular tissue, but on the front of the package, it said craft tissue. So I'm almost thinking it may have been. Oh, I didn't see the splatter. I didn't ignore it, Janet. No, it wasn't you, Jillian? Okay. Stencil wipeout. We'll call it stencil wipeout. I'll explain it to Jen when I write it down. She might be able to come up with a better name. Glass bead gel. Ooh. All right. I missed splatters, so let's put that down. Glass bead gel. If I miss it, just say it again. It's just because I wasn't looking, because I was writing something else down. Yep, we have masks, Debbie. Yep. Oh, Debbie, of course. Gosh. Sheesh. Such an obvious one. Stamping. Goodness gracious. Yep, modeling paste. That's texture. Yeah, I've got that one, Vicky. Texture paste. Okay, Jillian. Well, that's definitely a good start. Ooh, bleach technique. See, that's a good one. Grunge paste. Doesn't that go with the texture paste, Eileen? Or how is that different? It's cool, Judy. You can either use it like splatter, sprinkle the bleach on watercolor, and it removes some of the color. It's kind of neat. Excuse me. Hello. Speaking. Yes. Okay. June 21st at 2:30. Okay. No, I don't yet. That's yeah. Oh, okay. So I just come right back to the clinic. Okay. All right, great. I'll see you then. Okay, thank you. Bye. Okay, glad I answered that one. Hate when they come through it. I better put that on my calendar now or I'll forget. It's my, the sleep therapy, it's not sleep therapy, the sleep doctor. My next appointment, yay! Okay, June 21st. Add. Please excuse me if you're watching on. Dumont. Oops. Hospital. At 2:30. Whoops, 2:30. And I need. To put my alerts the day before and whoops, an hour before add. Excellent. Sorry about that. Had to put it on my calendar. Do apologize. Oh, you're going to do that video? Cool, Z. Excellent. Yeah, Janet. Okay. All right, so I'm going to put Xander's name beside that one. So Jen may want to put that at the top of the list and the date that that one's getting done, so we can give people the heads up to collect their supplies. Yeah, so what we'll do is those of us who are kind of helping Jen with this, with the techniques, we can, you know, tell her, oh, I'd like to do this one and I'm going to do it on this date. And the minute we have it planned, we can perhaps put it up on the Facebook group or Twitter and or wherever, so that people can get ready and collect things. Ooh, good one, UT, Zandra. Yeah. UT. Should say, yeah, UT and embossing powder, right? But, yeah, we have embossing powder and another one. So UT is kind of a different technique all of its own. Okay. Is using prints and mixing patterns. Okay, so if there are any more, send me ideas in a tweet and I'll add them to the list and send an email out to Jen. And then she can take it from there. How's that? Or you can send the idea yourself directly to Jen if you follow her on Twitter or Facebook. Oh, definitely, Jenna. Yes, 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 yes. Pattern making. Yeah, Lynn, she is. Cat Hand is doing mixed media morsels. So she's doing different techniques too. So if you follow her, you'll get... All right, so I have... Uh-oh. Who remembers where I put my image to dry? Oh, never mind. It's right here. Ah, it's not quite dry, so I'm going to look through here. I had one other idea that I needed. Would like to try and find an image of... Oh! Good. Oh. Anyway. Seeing this image gives me a really cool journal page idea. Yeah, on Facebook, if you go to Cat Hand, not Facebook, YouTube, if you go to YouTube, Cat Hand, C-A-T-H-A-N-D, is the YouTube channel. And she's doing a series called Mixed Media Morsels. And she just does it on a small little page from a little, small, tiny little, like, binder that she has. Like a, maybe 3x4 or 4x5 size little binder. Just have an idea, but I may have enough for my page already anyway. I may have too much for my page already. Fashionable, flattering facial hair. Unlike the unfashionable, unflattering facial hair, which many seem to wear. Oh, look at that. Do's and don'ts. That has to get cut out for a journal page, definitely. Well, not sure how that skewer got inside my Alright, oh, okay, here's what I was wondering. Nope. Not what I wanted. Okay, I guess I'm just gonna say I have enough. Hmm. That's the cruise line I love. Okay, those are going over here. All right. So today's page is brought to you by the Canadian National Anthem. Ah. Hey, Vicky. Welcome, welcome. And if I missed anyone else coming in, I do apologize. All right. Let's find my page. And it's going to need gesso. This is one of the older Diane Reevely journals. Oh, I've even got a page falling out there. Uh-oh. So, we were talking about one of the techniques of using a coloring book page on a in an art journal layout, and there's a coloring book page that I colored and then added into my journal page. Be someone's sunshine today. I am doing coloring book transfers, but I'm doing other technique. I'm using it on a journal page, so I'm doing like other things too. I'm doing several different kinds of image transfer techniques actually. So that poor page. I remember that stream. That was a what not to do stream. Don't do this stream. This is one of my favorite layouts still. That was my very first ever image transfer, and look how good it turned out. I mean, oh. So I love this page. Love that page. Yeah. That was another image transfer. All right, here I go. Thanks, Vicky. I know, eh? Great. It's just some random Canadian actor, but it was the best face I was wanting to try in image transfer. So I just kind of put him in there. I should have tried to find one of the Beatles, but oh well. What can you do? There we go. All right. Let's start with some gesso. Can't reach the darn stuff. Uh-oh. Lost my white paint. One moment, please. The white paint fell on the floor off my cart. Actually, I had it on a shelf here, ready to go. Uh-oh. I'm going to need something long to help guide it close to me. Ruler time. Life with short arms. Going to need that white paint. La, 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 la. Oh, I forgot to print something. I went to print something. My printer was unplugged and then I forgot to print it. All right. One moment, please, while I print something. File. Print. Fine. Print. There we go. All right. Hey, Cindy. Ugh, I have to do this every time. I do have a grit. Now I don't know what I do with it. I even washed all my brushes today and got myself some clean water, so I'm all ready to go. And I even have some new roll of paper towel in my room. Ha! Huh. Almost ready today. Of course, then Chrome had to be a pain in the butt and almost didn't let me in. Okay. I've got a pile of stuff here that I'm going to be using today. Some stuff I might use, some stuff I know I'm going to use. All right, here we go. Gesso. This is the old Dylusions journal, so the pages definitely need gesso. I'm not going to waste it, though. I am going to use it. Uh-oh. You know what? I think I'm going to go on to the next page. These may stick together, but that's okay, because that page is, and I should actually just put some gel medium here, so it does stick together on purpose. Because there's a rip in the side of the page, and that side of the page is going to be very important to part of my page today. So I am going to, on purpose, glue these together so that edge is stronger. Putting gel medium over the whole thing. This is my gel medium. I put it in this little container because I have a great big huge bottle of gel medium, and it doesn't squirt out well, so it's a better way to control it. Because Eileen's knows, I'll just say no. Poor Z last night. Z had an idea in her mind. She was making background paper. She knew what she wanted to do, and Eileen was giving her advice. But it got all mixed up in the chat, because Z was thinking one thing and Eileen was thinking another. I was trying to help Eileen's point get across, but eh. Poor Z. Z, you just have to learn to say, no, Eileen, that's okay. This is how I'm going to do it. Hey, Sandy! Yeah, they were. The cards were gorgeous. It was funny because I could just tell you were making backgrounds for cards, and Eileen was giving this idea to stack all the different colors on top of each other. But she wanted you to do it to make new tissue, not backgrounds. But you were reading it, trying to make it into a new background. Very funny. I can see my brush is still dirty from being in water, even though I soaked it and washed it. But that's okay, because white paint will be going over this anyway. This is just to prep the page. Oh! I put that in the wrong... Darn it. I want that in my gesso water. Okay. No, I know, Sandy. I was trying to help Eileen. Exactly. I was part of the problem. But I was trying to tell Z that, no. Eileen was saying to make new paper. I was like just trying to make Z see what Eileen was, anyway. That's okay. I should know better than to partner up with Eileen. I'm not sure why Eileen's so quiet. Why are you so quiet? Oh, she was having Eileen was having trouble with chat. So she may have just given up trying to get back in. Yeah, she's having storms and stuff, so. So, Janet, if you want help with Maud, not that there's normally, I haven't had a troll come in quite a while, but if you want help with Maud issues, you can Maud someone, Ella, or someone who wouldn't mind helping you out, if someone's going to be here the whole time. Whatever. Hey, Teresa! Nice to see you. It's been a while. Yeah, Vicky. No, poor Diane. Packer Di was the one who used to attract the trolls because her stream name was Late Night Jammy Journalers. Used to be. Now she's the Heart Studio, but when she first started streaming, she was Late Night Jammy Journals because Elliot was a couple of months old when she started. And she used to stream late at night when Gracie was in bed and Elliot was sleeping in one arm and she'd be arguing with the other. And it'd also be silent so that she wouldn't wake Elliot up. Those are great nights. A new secret mod? Yeah. Still a little wet. Even the gesso doesn't dry quick on this paper. It's really weird. It's gesso on nice paper dries. Now the new journals apparently have much nicer paper, so we'll see. Yep, they were awesome times, Vicky. Oh, and Stick'em, didn't we have fun in Stick'em at late night? Oh, man. Oh, I know they closed down because of some of the issues they had, but we had fun. Stick'em was awesome. It's much better than Hangouts because in Hangouts, once you have 10 people in the room, no one else can come in. But with Stick'em, you could have 12 people on video and you could have any numerous number of people in the room in the chat who, if they didn't want to be on video. So we could have 50 or 60 people in the room. And I mean, only 12 could be on video or audio, but the others could still chat in live chat. It was so fun. I'm doing a journal page, Kathy, and I'm going to be using a bunch of different image transfers, including some coloring book pages, that some that are colored and some that are not colored. I'm using coloring book images as transfers. So we shall see how it works out. All right. House mouse. Yeah. Oh, and the mouse in the house. Yeah. Well, it's like kind of like Darcy and Jonna still do the mouse in the house. They have one on. We used to do that. Someone would stream and one person would be on Skype to help them read the chat and stuff like that. Yeah, that was fun. Oh, yeah, Paula used to get an occasional troll. See, that still feels a little cool. It still feels like it's not dry. Which is weird, because that gesso should be dry. But that was a lot of heat gunning. What I printed out. Oh, perfect size too. So, need to cut it out. I hate cutting. I might use my bigger scissors because it's nothing, it's not really intricate. It's mostly straight lines. So if I use my longer nosed scissors, I might get straighter lines. Oh. Oh, sorry about that, Sandy. I hope she's okay. How old is she? I think I'll paint this before I put it on the page, but cut it out first. Should paint it before I cut it out, so. Is this the closest red I have? I think it is. Let's see. Our flag is a real like cherry red. Like a pure primary red. Oh, that's a metallic red. It might be nice though. Those are more orange. So I think this is the best red that I have. Alrighty. When you use the Tim Holtz big scissors, if you turn the signature towards you, you won't get a serrated edge on your cut. What do you mean? Oh no. Well, don't worry, I've got years of KFC plates hanging out around here. I'm not going to wear it. Years worth. Years and years. Yeah, that's a nice red. I'm being careful around the red, around the black, because I'd rather not have to. I can go over it again in black, obviously, if I, but, you know, I'd rather not have to, because I can't write straight. Draw straight lines any better than I can paint them, so. Oops! Ha! My paintbrush is falling apart because I'm really bad about leaving it in. Oh, headache and the rash? Oh. Yes, I know that, Ella. You mean the meningitis? Do you mean meningitis, Sandy? I think that might be what she means. Maybe. Oh, Sandy. Poor thing. Well, we'll be thinking of her and sending hugs and prayers over the pond for your granddaughter, Molly. Yeah, should have used a straight or an angled brush instead of this, whatever they call filbert. Yeah, that's what I thought you meant, Sandy. But what do you mean by the Oh, you mean the signature on the... Oh, do you know why I was confused, Ella? When you said signature, I wasn't thinking, okay, here's what Ella means. The signature on the scissors. The signature on the scissors. It's so funny because when you were saying signature, I thought you meant like the paper signature, like the fold of the paper towards you. So, Ella said, when you cut, if you put the signature towards you, then you don't get the serrated edge. Oh, because only one of the blades is serrated. So then the flat blade is on the top. Ha! Very cool, Ella. I didn't know that. Great tip. Yeah. I didn't even notice that about the blades before, that one was serrated and one wasn't. May have to. See, I'm not good with a paintbrush like Miss Dee Dee is. You know what she meant, Sandy? Hey, L.A. Nice to see you. L.A. is Army Mom Linda. Linda Army L.A. That's how I got her shortcut name. Or her nickname, I should say. Linda Army, also known as L.A. Because we've got quite a few Lindas in our group, so you have to tell them apart. One night we even had, Linda White Holloway and we had two Linda Whites. We had Linda White Holloway, we had Linda White Churchill, and then we had a Linda White one night in a stream. And I think, if I remember correctly, all three are Canadian. Need a little more red. I know, Sandy, and I almost did that, except I'm going to paint the rest of the flag on my page, so I wanted the reds to match, because it's too hard to get the reds to match. So that's, Sandy said she would have just painted this, or printed it on red paper, or actually printed it as a red maple leaf, which I could have filled it in red. But the reason I didn't was I wanted, because I'm using more of this red on the page, I wanted the reds to match. So now the reason I'm doing this page is because at the moment in Parliament, there is an argument or a conversation, whatever you want to call it, going on. One of the MPs, I don't know if it's just one, but there's one in particular, wants the words of our national anthem to be changed to make it politically correct. Now, in one spot in our anthem, it says, "In all thy sons command." And they don't want the word "all thy sons command" in there. It's like, really? They don't mean men. If you can't understand English, go back to school. You know, just because they say son or man doesn't mean, you know, literally son or man. Like, give me a break, people. Ugh. Drives me batty. Yeah, well, I'm surprised I stayed inside the lines as well as I did, Vicky. Leave a little wrinkle, but hey, it's gonna be like a flag, so if it's wrinkled, it'll look like the flag's waving, so no big deal to me as far as the wrinkles, but I wanted the red to match, so that was important. The red matching was very important. So I'll go from the back, it'll help get rid of some of the wrinkles. Not that I care. It is, Terry, I agree. So, I'm doing a journal page about it because it bothers me. Interesting. I've got something built up on the spout of my heat gun. Oh, it's my heat gun falling apart. It's melting. Oh! I thought it was like a piece of paper or something that had, look, my heat gun's falling apart. Uh-oh. I just burnt myself too. See, the gray coating is melting and coming off. I just noticed that. Oh. Oh, just a moment, please. Just gonna get a baby wipe here. Hey, Allie, sorry, I missed you coming in. Yeah, I know, it does look like a fire hazard, doesn't it? Guess it's time to buy a new heat gun, but this is gonna have to do me until next payday. Can't afford a new heat gun right now. And I don't use my heat gun as much as some of you do. Although I've used it more in the last couple years than I did when I first got it. Yeah, I'm okay. Just, I burned my thumb because I didn't realize when I was first trying to get it off, I didn't realize the metal was exposed, that it would be that hot. So I thought it was something. I was looking from this side and it just looked like a piece of glue or something, right? It just looked like a piece of glue or a big blob of paint stuck to it. Yeah. Ooh, that is stinging though. All right, it's dry. It's dry. Oh, I see, Carol. Okay, okay, okay. Oh, shoot. That hurt. Okay. Now I can go back to cutting, and I'm going to cut with the Tim Holtz signature towards me. All right, hold on a minute. I'm gonna cut most of it away so I can do it a little bit of an easier way here. Maybe. All right, so I'm hoping that has enough layers on it. We'll find out, won't we? Mm-hmm. All right. It'll be fine as long as I don't touch it again. The metal's still there. There's no wires exposed. It's just the plastic melting off. I'll just make sure not to use it too long at a time. So, don't worry. Be happy. And it's sticking to my page. Yeah, it'll be easier to get off this, so I'm just going to. It's it's the kind that we're all breaking down there, Vicky. Embossing. I don't know. I can't see it. I can't see it through the paint. You know that brand where they had some of the recent ones broke down? Embossing heat tool. I don't know. I can't see the name. Oh, no. I can't see the name because it, I'll cover with paint. Yeah, Marvy, thank you. Yes, it's a Marvy Uchida one, Vicky. Yep. Oh, now if it was a frayed cord, Ella, I wouldn't use it. Or if there were wires exposed, I wouldn't use it. It's just the plastic coating that's over top of the metal as a protective thing so you don't burn yourself as badly like I just did on my thumb. But it's not blistering yet, so it should be okay. It's just stinging. Yeah, so So now that I have my doctor's appointment, I'm probably going to have, I won't have any money for a couple of months because I'll have to buy my CPAP machine. It'll be 80% covered, but still going to be a substantial amount that I have to pay. For a minute there when she said it was, she was calling from the George Dumont Hospital, I was thinking, I can't be the surgeon calling already for my appointment. So I think what I'm actually going to do, should I actually cut that or should I just fold it and put, because it's thin, I might be okay with just folding it. Yeah, I'm going to go on Amazon and I'll just get the best deal. The Milwaukee one is nice because it has more than one heat layer or choice. No, Vicky. But the doctor just called here during the stream. I finally got my call back. Well, he'll give me the results from my test and I assume order a sleep study. Or, I mean, the CPAP machine, I mean. Okay, so this will be fine with just matte medium. So I'm going to use just matte medium on this. And a little... Oh, Terry, you don't have to do that. I'm in up in Canada. It'll cost a fortune for you to mail it. Oh, good idea, Carol. Thank you. That's a good idea. I'll just kind of... Right in the... yeah. What to do with my... There it is. Okay. Good idea. Carol said to paint... right behind the leaf with red in case the paper splits. Well, and these books are well known for... The, spine is splitting, that's for sure. I don't have to wait for it to dry because that will just help the, that'll just help my maple leaf stick. Uh-oh. Ah! Turn it all. I let it stay open. Oh, Terry, well, thank you very much. Actually, Teresa, I'm feeling pretty good. I mean, other than the whole sleep thing. I slept good last night, but I didn't get to bed. I didn't get to sleep till late because I was thinking about my sister who was at the ER. So even after she wrote me that she was home from the ER, and then it was beyond that point where I was tired, so it still took an hour to get to sleep. No, hi, Tina. I did not blow up my heat gun, Tina. It's melting. Look. It's melting. So the plastic coating's melting away from the metal tip. Well, Vicky, she's okay. She just has, on top of all her back pain, she has scoliosis, she has severe arthritis in her back, and she has two crushed discs. Oh, no! Oh! Uh-oh! Oops. I didn't need that much matte medium. Whoopsie. Whoops. Anyway, so on top of the pain from the discs and the arthritis and the scoliosis, she's now having severe pain, even worse than her back pain, in her right hip. And on Monday, the doctor said it was bursitis, gave her stronger pain meds to take, and it got worse and worse. And by yesterday, she was like, she had to leave work early. She was supposed to be on late shift. She got as much work done as she could and left early and went to the ER. She did get in to see the doctor, and he gave her a shot for the pain right away, which was good. Hold on, please. And but then, and gave her, got x-rays taken, but then they got so busy at the ER, she said ambulances were coming in every 5 minutes. And of course, in the evening, they have fewer doctors on anyway. And they, I mean, they have ER doctors on call that they call in, but they only call them in for acute cases. They don't call them on for the sitting in and waiting in severe pain cases. So she had to leave before she got the results from the x-ray because she had to try and get some sleep and try and go into work today. So I don't even know if she went into work today. I sent her an email. She hasn't replied yet. So yeah, so she's worried that it's infection and not just bursitis. She's worried some kind of infection has set in the bone or something like that because it was getting worse after pain medication should have eased it some. Your pain shouldn't be getting worse after pain meds. So, anyway. The injection did help her some, though, she said. So, all right. So now, I'm going to take to see you. Oh, really, Vicky? Bye, Terry. Sorry. Okie dokie. Thanks for coming. Oh. All right, I've got some stuff all over the place here, so I'm just going to heat gun it. So I can't use my black marker until this is all dry. So, yeah, Sandy. I mean, I have pain too, and my knees bother me, and with my lymphedema, it's kind of like an ache and a pressure kind of pain. But oh, I've seen my sister, and hers is nerve pain, and that's even worse. Nerve pain is much worse than what I deal with, so I try not to complain too often. I do have a hair dryer, but I'm fine. Okay, so I mean, marijuana is legal in New Brunswick with a prescription from the doctor. And it's a licensed shop. You know, you have to get it at a licensed whatever. But it's not that I disagree with it in that case, but I don't agree with you doing it illegally, because illegal is illegal, in my opinion. You can't question laws if you would disagree with them or not. You shouldn't be questioning them. Do what you can to get them changed. That's just how I feel. Oh, I want my other. I don't like that one as much. This one has better lines for me to get things straight. Okay, so I only want to go down to... Alright, I'm going to start... Let's start at the 1 inch. Let's put the 1 inch up there. Okay, good. Still have some wet medium here, so I have to be careful. Sorry. I know. I'm always the one that's getting after Jonna and Darcy, but I go down to 10. And a half. 10 and a half. That looks good. Whoa, my flag is really waving here. Yeah, maybe I should have done it crooked so it does look like it's waving. Oh well, too late now. Depends, Janet. It's not less harmful than alcohol if you're a person who has a tendency to have addictions. That's all I'm saying. If you are a person who is prone to addictions, marijuana is not good. Just saying. And I know I have an addictive personality because food is my drug of choice. Unfortunately, yes, it's going to kill me probably slower than another addiction would, but all right, so this goes red and I am going to use my little piece of paper here over top of here, just so I don't have to worry about being too neat. Guess I'm gonna need another one. Okay, I think I'm gonna need, maybe I should just use tape. So I'm gonna get my painter's tape here. Sandy. All right, here we go. So, I just took some of the, even though it's painter's tape, I still took some of the sticky off it. I should also... Oh, great, Jean. Brilliant. It'll go across the bottom here. Didn't make it long enough. So, you know what I find very interesting is the number of people who have found us on here on Ustream. Because we're talking about, for those of you watching the recording, we're talking about pain and pain medications and such of that in the chat. And it's very interesting to discover the number of people in our group that have found us and follow us around Ustream that are in one way or another affected by pain in their lives, fibromyalgia, back issues, health issues, and, you know, use art as a therapy option. I just think it's very interesting. All right, I'm going to put this on top because this one's going to move. This one on the bottom is going to stay there for the white as well. So I'm just going to put this one on top, and I'm going to put this one on top as well. There we go. Okay. All right. This way I don't have to worry about being neat. And that's good. I like it when I don't have to worry about being neat. Oh. Need another paper towel. With my brush to wet. Okay. And hopefully, most of you recognize this as the Canadian flag. This may need two coats because red's not the most opaque color, and I do want it to be pretty opaque. So I have other things I can do while I'm letting this dry. Okay, so I am going to put this aside for a moment while I peel off my O Canada here and see how it worked. So what I did with this, I found this on an envelope. I left it bigger than I want it so I can trim it down later. I used 4 layers of gel medium matte, letting it dry in between each one over top. Now I'm going to take off the paper and it will leave behind like a decal. That's the theory. Hopefully I have enough layers. All right, here goes the water on the back, and I'm going to start rubbing. So, you can see the paper's peeling off right away. This was just from a this was from a brochure for our city, or my town, I should say. It's not, I live in Riverview, which is a town, part of the Tri-City. Moncton is, Tri-City area is Moncton, Dieppe. Dieppe is a city, Riverview is a town. But that's the kind of metro area. But our town puts out, every season, no, twice a year, fall and winter, spring and summer, brochures with all the recreational activities. So you can see the word Canada there coming through. I think the Olympics are end of July, beginning of August. I'm not sure of the date exactly. Like 2.5 weeks there, somewhere along the line. But it's going to be very interesting. Brazil's government is in disarray. There's the Zika virus. Yeah. Interesting. They're trying to oust, Brazil's trying to oust their president, you know, the year that they have the Olympics coming. It's very interesting. I think maybe I should just put it right on here because this paper's being more of a pain than it's being a help right now. All right, needs a little more to come off. It's a little thin. I probably could have used one or more, two coats. I don't want to rip it. It's pretty thin. I'm going to go very gentle. And it was gray that was around it, so I think I've got it all off. Feels pretty smooth. All right, so now I'll put it on something white to show you what I've got. Would have been nicer if it was on white. Hey, Victor. Hello, hello. Hi, Rebecca. No, it's just the paper. And what I did was I put 4 layers of gel medium, drying it in between each one, Vicky. So there's no packing tape, so it's not shiny because I used matte medium. So that's the option you can use if you don't want that shiny packing tape image. No, it's not packing tape. Gel medium, matte, not matte medium, gel medium. Would have been nicer if it had been on white initially. Now I'm going to trim it and make it smaller. It's a little dark on this side, but that's okay. That's what color it was on, like a gray mottled background. Yeah. All right, so now I'm going to trim it down. This is why I left it bigger than I want. That way I can trim it after in case I messed up some edges or whatever. And that way, if you mess up edges, you can trim it off. Dropped it. Good thing it didn't land on the floor. It's not my idea. Someone suggested it. Someone was talking about it the other day. Can't remember. In someone's room. Can't remember who it was that was talking about it. But anyway, I was like, oh, I can do that. Because I don't like the shininess of the paper of packing tape transfers. So I'll use this instead. How cool is that? When you want to have your text or whatever you're transferring, when you don't want it to be backwards, then you can use this technique. So anytime you have print, you can use this. Yeah, and then you rub off the back. Just spritzed it with water and rubbed it off. Oh, cool idea. Yes, Carol. So if you have a candle, a votive candle, right? You could put this on a votive candle because you can curve it, or a domed, a textured surface, or a curved surface, or something like that. Yeah. Good idea, huh? Yeah. So thanks to whoever mentioned it and gave me the idea, because I specifically wanted, I was like, oh, I want to find something that I can use that technique on it so I can practice. And so then I saw this image and I thought, perfect. Perfect way to use that, because it's text and... Now to put that somewhere where it won't get lost until I need it. Take my book back. And sorry, guys. Oh, explain it again? Sure. So this was, this is our Canadian government logo. Okay. Canada with the maple leaf. That's our Canadian government logo. So anything that's sponsored by the Canadian government, this is their logo for advertising. Okay. So it was on the back page of a magazine for, the recreational activities for the town of Riverview that I live in. So I simply took it, trimmed it out bigger than I wanted it. Actually, I tore it. Took my gel medium, I used four coats. I might have used one more maybe. But it isn't tearing, so it's not bad actually. I used four coats of gel medium, drying in between each one, letting it dry between each coat. Then turned it over, and just like every other image transfer, spritzed the back, rubbed the paper off, and then you get this cool thing that you can add to your collage or your whatever. Gel medium, not matte. Gel medium matte. You could use gloss too if you like the look of gloss. Yep. Yeah, gel medium matte. Well, just because because gel medium's thicker, you could use matte medium, but you'd have to use a lot more layers, right? Because it's thinner. So you could use matte medium. You could use Mod Podge. Anything that dries clear would work. If you use matte medium, though, you'd have to do more layers in order to get it thick enough that it won't rip. Right, it becomes transparent. Right, it becomes transparent, and unlike normal image transfers with text, it stays the correct way around. See, I mean, it's transparent because if I hold it up, if I put it like this, you can see that it's backwards, right? Actually, Carol, I put it on and then I wiped it with my finger so I wouldn't have the brush, strokes. Yeah, you could use Mod Podge, Vicky, yeah. Any medium that dries clear will work. So even if you had the Elmer's glue all that dries clear, that would work too. Use what you have. I just have, mine's a Curry's gel medium. Yeah, Mod Podge will work. Oh yeah, Mod Podge will work. It'll work fine. Make sure each layer's dry. That's pretty well dry. just want to do another layer of red. I did, Kathy. I did. It didn't work great because I didn't leave the transparency dry long enough. I'll show you. See the art journal techniques? Those words? I did that from a transparency on last week's stream. Now, it didn't work well, but it was my fault. I didn't do the transparency enough ahead to give it time to dry long enough on the transparency. So it didn't get to dry long enough. That was my fault. It's not the technique's fault. It would have come out better had I let it dry longer on the sheet, on the transparency sheet. So, all right, Sarah, see you later. Yeah, Vicky, I thought the matte Mod Podge is not as bad as the glossy, but I mean, that's kind of the same with any. If you use glossy by Liquitex or Golden, it's going to be stickier too. But yes, Mod Podge tends to be a little stickier than matte medium when it dries. It can be, especially in some environments, apparently. That's looking better. Need a little bit more because I have one other side to do. Second coat on. I do need a second coat on that leaf too, I think. And now I'm going to choose some images from coloring book pages that I'm going to add to this page for texture. And I have a couple of things. I'm going to use the one that I was coloring on Monday. I only have three leaves colored, but I'm going to do something else with the other leaves. So I have an idea of how I can use it anyway. Oh, that's kind of gross. What do I have in my... big ugly blob. There we go. I'll take care of that blob. I'm getting red other places. I hope my white's gonna cover it. Make sure, yep, I'm still recording. Good, good, good. Everything's looking good. I can't get into Ustream with Firefox anymore. I just keep getting the initializing blue turny thing. And Chrome even gave it to me the first time. I had to try a second time to get in. Just gonna try and make sure I get in the center with the... More of my poor paintbrush is falling apart. All right, so while that's drying, I am going to use this page. Now, I am going to I will paint before I trim it out. So what I want to do with this, these are done with Prismacolor color pencils. The rest I'm going to do with some markers, and I may use, oh, where's my yellow one? Dang it all. I may have to use some yellow. I don't know where my yellow one went. I lost my, the silly things fell on the floor. And I think some of, obviously I should say, no, I don't think, obviously some of them rolled under something or the other. Okay, so I need some of that, and I need some light green. All right, so I'm gonna have to use a combo of paint and my paint pens, paint markers here. Okay, all right, thanks, Sandy. Thanks for dropping in. Bye-bye. I hope Molly's okay. All right, so I'm going to use a smaller paintbrush for this, just because I'll have more control. This is the one I should have used in the first place. All right, I'll use a round one, I guess. I might be able to do it with this. We'll see. See what I can figure out. So I'm going to paint some of these. All right, this one's going to be green and yellow. So I need some yellow. Need some light green. Make sure the light green doesn't get anywhere near the red, or I'll end up with brown. Okay. Some of it is Artist Loft. The green is Artist Loft, yes. Yes, the yellow is Artist Loft as well. So I'm using my paint dry on a dry brush. So that, and I don't necessarily want it to be, I don't mind if it's a little translucent actually at all. I can add some detail to it once it's on the page as well. So I'm not necessarily worried about getting really good detail right now. I just want to get some color on them. So we're going to compare how these transfer with paint versus pencil crayon, because these are acrylic paint markers, my Posca markers, and acrylic paint. So we're going to see the difference. Oh, yeah. The red is Liquitex Basics. Sorry. In something. Let me get my app out so I can give you the color. Let's see. Because I know some people really want to know the color. All right. get my mag app out here so I can see. All right, the red was naphthol crimson. Naphthol crimson. Naphthol crimson by Liquitech Basics. The yellow, I think, is deep yellow because it's my favorite yellow. Yeah, deep yellow by Artist Loft. Love their deep yellow. I love it. And green yellow by Artist Loft. How's that? Does that work for you? Yes, this is going to be a transfer, Terry. These are medium point, Vicky, but you would, because you like to color and will probably write with them in your en masse journal and whatever, the fine point ones are really nice too. I do have the extra fine, and those are nice for coloring, getting into small areas like this. But this particular set is the medium point. But yes, I have the extra fine set too. So. Now I'm gonna try and do a little blending here and see what happens. It's probably too dry. I can fix the blending with pencil crayons later anyway. That's blending nicely. Okay, so that works. Okay. This one's going to be reds and oranges because this one is green, so that it's different. So I'm going to do some red at the center. This is one-sided. It's fairly good thick paper. It's from the Canada to Color coloring book that I got at Costco, $10.99 for a very nice thick coloring book. I don't want to blend with my markers just because I'm not sure how the transfer will work. I don't really want to totally mess up the tips of my paint markers. Watercolor markers you can, because it will come off, but this is acrylic paint, so I don't want to mess up one color. So I'm going to do it with a brush, the blending part. So I don't mess up my brush. Here we go. Like I said, I can do some more detailed blending later. And the light. So apparently Dee Dee bought another coloring book at Hobby Lobby today. So it shall be very interesting to see what coloring book she has purchased now. journal page, and I'm going to use, this is the coloring page I started on Monday. These three were done with Prisma colors. These ones I'm doing with acrylic paint because I'm actually going to use this as a transfer onto my journaling page. So I'm testing out using coloring book pages as jelly, as image transfers. Went over that one. That one's going to have to be green underneath there. I don't care about going over here because this part's getting cut out. All right. So there's that, but I think I want to add a little yellow out around the edges there. So I just want to blend in a little bit of yellow here. Deep yellow is pretty transparent. Darn it all. Wasn't very careful there, was I? But it will brighten up. It's transparent, but it will still brighten up the orange around the edges here of this one, of this leaf. Yep. You don't have to be neat with this because leaves aren't like perfect, right? So I'm just kind of adding a little texture in here. Actually, it looks good. Sometimes you do something by accident and it's like, that looks good. Add a little texture. Nice. Okay, I like that. Nice. Okay. So now this one in behind here is another one that's going to be green. So I'm going to start off with yellow. With the yellow green in the middle here. Thank you, Vicky. Terry. Yeah, well, I'm definitely going to have to start using what I have for the summer. It's not like I need anything. I have plenty of money. I just like to spend it all, that's all. So I have to stop doing that. So I don't have to, like, eat peanut butter sandwiches for the rest of the month, and even that's not cheap. Okay, so now my green. Ah! That has like red all over the back of it. I'm not quite sure where that red came from. Yuck. Where did the red? I don't know where I let it. Anyway. This is all going to get trimmed off. I just figured I may as well paint it while it's whole here. What time is it? Oh, 4 o'clock. So I've still got an hour on my recording, so that's good. Surprising how long it takes to do this. It's not like you can always necessarily just like rip these out in an hour or anything. And I don't like to pre-prep too much, although I did have my 3 layers of medium already on the Canada transfer. Okay, this poor brush. It's just a cheap brush, so they keep spreading out on me. Won't stay together because it's just cheap acrylic brush. Acrylic bristles. Dollarama, but hey. It's not like I don't take care of my brushes, so I can't get good ones. Terry went from peanut butter sandwiches to Reese's peanut butter cups. Ugh! Ugh. You guys are bad. See? If you come here to our streams, be prepared because they always end up talking about food. It was my fault this time because I talked about eating peanut butter sandwiches, but that was all they needed. Peanut butter sandwiches, and all of a sudden everybody goes to food. Food, food, food. And then we all get hungry. Yep. Oh, I pressed a wee bit too hard on that one. Oh, hold on. Like I said, a mistake can end up being a blessing in disguise because I'm getting a really cool kind of aqua tealy green here, mixing that blue, the green yellow, the other green. With the lighter. Oops. See? Like Carolyn Doobie says, oops is an outstanding opportunity presenting suddenly. And look at the cool, because I pressed too hard and got out too much. I'll go over these eventually and put some more black lines in these. But look how cool that ended up. I don't know. Oh, sorry, was I off screen for that whole thing? I'm sorry. I'll take a picture of it, Denise, before I cut it up. I'm gonna do some more of that green on there because it's just like too cool. So I had some black. I'll add the lines back in there later in all of these painty ones. The pencil crayon ones I did already, but yeah. Okay, good, good, good. All right. I wasn't looking, so I was worried I was off screen. All right, so this one's going to be red. Right, so I'll do this one next because this one's going to be green here. I'm gonna see. Center of it is. So that one, do that one red. Yeah, okay, so I'll do this one green and I'll do that little piece of one under there, orangey and red. So this is going to be a green one, a green leaf. And now, don't press, Jean. Just color. You don't have to push these very often. You might have to push them if you haven't used them in a while, but they stay pretty nice and juicy. So I don't know why I pushed on it, but anyway. It was a mistake that turned out quite nicely, actually, huh? There we go. Little blending. See, so you can blend with your Posca markers. See, look at that. How nice is that? And it would work if I had my lighter green Posca marker too. I would be able to blend my two colors of Posca markers because it is acrylic paint. So. Jen is going to be on at 9 p.m. Eastern time, which is 10 for me. It is 10, 11, 12, 1 a.m. 2 a.m. for the UK. And for Australia, no idea. I think it's 10 o'clock for her where she is. 10 o'clock on Friday morning, I believe, for her in... No, 9, Ella. 9 Eastern. I'm on at 1. Yeah. Okay, so... Yes, 6 p.m. for the West Coasters. Pacific time zone. All right, so let's hit that there. All right, so the rest of these, oh, this one. Okay, this one I'm going to do like this one so that it's mostly yellow, so that it's different from this one with the oranges. So I'm going to do this one mostly yellow so that it is different. So I'm going to do some yellow first. Oh, there's actually a little green on my brush still, so that's okay. That works out perfectly. A little green, a little yellow. That's perfect, actually. Very nice. See all these messy brush techniques. Works perfectly. All right. There's a little red in the paint, too, just from the... When I was... Or a little orangey or with it. Oh, that has... Oh, no. Okay, just a second. That stem goes here. All right. This stem goes with this one that I'm coloring now. So I think I want to add, okay, I'm going to take out a little, still have a little wet red here. So I'm going to take out some of that red and I'm going to take a little bit of the yellow. See if I can get some orange here. I could use my marker, but I already have acrylic paint, so I don't want to put my paint marker. I don't want to wreck the tip. Didn't need that much yellow. I don't think. Maybe I did. Okay, I guess because the yellow is so transparent, it's not mixing. It's making kind of a reddish, but that'll work. I'll use it. I'll make it work. All right, hold on. I need to get some. I've got too much paint on the brush. There we go. Now let's just get a little mixable paint here. Yeah, no, I don't like that. Don't like that. It's not what I want. I think I would rather go back and add some green. I didn't like that at all. Don't like that idea. I'd rather do a little green with my yellow here. There we go. There. Okay, I think that works. All right. Sorry, I'm not watching. Oh no, Carol. Yeah, well, I'm going to be disabled, retired too very soon. All right, so this one, I'm going back to my red marker. This is going to be like a sugar maple. And my oranges. Let's wet my brush. Clean my brush, I should say. I do want to get the green off it for this one because I know leaves get brown, but I don't want them brown yet. I don't want them dead. I want them nice and vibrant. I want it to be the prettiest part of fall. Just as they're changing and vibrant and colorful. A little bit teary, but not much. I'll go over them again. Once I do the transfer, I'll go over them. I'll add in some black lines. So, and we'll see what transfers too. Some of those lines may transfer, even though I can't see them much through the paint. So, that's what the experiment is all about. See what happens once you transfer. All right, so let's clean off that brush a little bit. And a little bit of yellow. I think I need some more yellow on my palette. Hey, Victor. Jen's not awake yet because it's still early morning over there for her. Yeah. Okay. So, I'm just using the yellow paint and the rest of the Posca's haven't quite dried yet, so And I'm using the yellow paint to help them blend a little bit. Yellow paint's fairly transparent, so it will just kind of make things a little vibrant if you don't use too much of it. Just kind of brightens the oranges and the reds up. And then if you use a little more of it, it will actually lighten things right up. So now I'm going to add a little more yellow to add some texture to the leaf. So I'm going to use it to add some texture. So I can still see the darker red, but this is just adding some yummy texture to my leaf. There we go. All right, now this is the edge of a maple leaf here, and I'm going to do it oranges and reds. Or I mean my two oranges, because the red would be further into the middle. So this would be my two oranges. Journal page, but I'm going to use this coloring book page as an image transfer just to see how it will work. I'm not worried about that because, like I said, I'm going to be trimming that part off anyway. So these are the three leaves I did with my Prisma colors, and all these ones I did today using acrylic paint and my Posca acrylic paint pens. So just adding a little yellow along the edge of this to define the edge. Details I will add once I transfer it over, like shading and all that kind of stuff. I will do that on